go ahead and start.
Are you going for U1?
Yes.
Then, yes, sir, I'll take one.
Good evening.
Good evening.
We're going to start singing. You can stand and turn to page 806 in your hymnal. I'd like to stay here longer in the west of the key.
What? It's the wrong key, isn't it?
I'd like to stay here longer.
God.
shall come. Good showers of acclamation. This is our Bobby Ashburn tribute, not memorial because he's sitting right there.
Share the Lord's been doing good for you. Anybody? Okay, well, we're going to move on. A few announcements. Again, we have Laura Crusoe here today with Choice Resources. The baby bottles are back there. And again, that's to collect change, cash, checks, whatever you want to put in there for choice resources. Again, she explained some of that to you today. And well, Shirley and some of you others at TC, and also TC and Sharita, it's good to see them back here with us tonight.
Yeah.
Give them a hand. God bless you. But anyway, we've got baby, have you ever heard of that?
Yes.
Okay, the baby bottle thing? Okay, but anyway, we did that a few years back, and it went really well. We've got about a month to get them back in. And again, with Choice Resources, I do appreciate that corporation. I say that because I think they are that way. They do have that in Charlestown now. New Albany's the main branch, but they've got it in two other places. I think they're gonna have five before they're done. But again, they are given, again, not just the choice of life versus abortion, but if you choose life, then you've got some help to give you some resources with what you need. So, you know, we can tell somebody that they're wrong all day long, but if we don't give them something to do with fixing it, then that's kind of just smacking them in the face sometimes. So I appreciate their, again, their ministry. I like to call it that all the way, but the other part too, because I know that they've got the tax credit and all that stuff. But anyway, if you can give to that and you'd like to take one of the baby bottles, just throw your change in it. I don't know about you, but I throw change on the top. It ends up on the floor and every place else all the time anyway. So again, you can do that, or if you want to put something in it. But anyway, you've got a month to do that if you haven't already took one or two of the baby bottles or whatever you like to. But again, that was the thing we had this morning. Also tomorrow night, Monday, we'll be having our men's meeting. You guys are welcome. TC, anytime you want to come over to our men's meeting, I know you've got your schedule full too, but you're always welcome. That'll be on Monday night at 7 p.m. tomorrow. The women's, Rita, you're always welcome too. That'll be the women's meeting at 6 p.m. They're an hour early. And then, of course, our church service is Wednesday. Thursday, we'll be having National Day of Prayer here on the square, sponsored by North Clark Ministerials Association. So again, if you'd like to be a part of that National Day of Prayer, God knows we need it for our nation.
Amen.
We'll be meeting together on a square on the gazebo that day, and that'll be at 12 o'clock noon. And then also Friday, there's something everything this week. But Friday night will be the movie night. What was that name again?
Gifted Hands.
Okay, so that'll be movie night Friday night, 7 p.m., and then also Steve will start the singing up on the square on Saturday, and that'll be at 10 a.m., and they did an excellent job over the past few years, sang along. And again, like I say, what I like about it is watching people drive by, and they won't stop, but they'll drive around a couple times just listening, so you know it's touching their heart. Again, that's what it's about, is trying to touch hearts. Hopefully God will bring people into salvation one way or another. Also, we've got Dallas Roger coming on the 22nd of this month. That's on a Sunday night. So actually he's going somewhere else, and this is going to be his brain back. Otherwise, I would have told him to come on Sunday morning. But also TC and Sharita with, again, Holy Trinity Christian Church has invited us to a community event on that day at 1 p.m. So that shouldn't interfere with that. And do you want to say something about that, TC?
The community event will host several professionals, one of which is Dr. Peter Latino, ER doctor at Clark Memorial. He will bring health awareness and information to encourage us to have our annuals, to continue to manage good health, and to make healthy choices, along with a registered nurse who will complement that topic of discussion. Then we will have a mental health specialist as well. We know that mental health is prevalent in our community. COVID-19 added to a lot of the stress factors associated with mental health. So that mental health professional will talk to us about signs and symptoms of mental health. And then we will have an educator to help encourage our youth to pursue higher learning, that they will go to college or pursue a trade. Many of the trades are dwindling. We encourage higher learning and to go to college and get a degree. However, they can have a good career in a trade as well. And trades are really diminishing again. So however way they choose, we want to encourage them to pursue a higher learning or trade so they can have a better future. After all of that, and that talk shouldn't last more than 30 minutes with all of those professionals, we're going to have a fellowship meal. And the fellowship meal will be delicious. Some of the best smoked pulled pork on the planet.
There we go. No.
Along with chicken thighs and legs and baked beans and coleslaw and all the trimmings. So it's going to be a time that we come together and have a fellowship meal and share our faith and love for Christ with one another. You're all invited.
Amen. Appreciate that. Give them a hand for that information. And I'll pass that on to our Sunday morning troops as well. So, yes, that will be at Maxwell's House of Music. That's where you're all actually having your meetings at now, too. But they're going to be having that outside in the tent, correct?
Yes.
So, again, we look forward to being a part of that if possible. And, again, like I say, that Dallas Rogers is going to be singing. That's going to be in our 6 o'clock service. So we can do that, get our belly full, take a 30-minute nap, get back to the choir, and we'll have the... We can do it, man. We can do it. So, again, these are some of the things that we're invited to with that and these other things coming up that I was letting you know about today. So, anyway, those are some of the things that we look forward to. Like I say, if you could come out with us Thursday for the National Day of Prayer, I'd appreciate everybody that could be a part of that. Again, it's going to be the ministers praying, but everybody's welcome to come along and be a part of that. If somebody really's got a prayer that they want to pray, I'm sure we're not going to... I'm the president over, so I'm sure I'll let you pray. So that's not going to be a problem. I'm not bragging. I'm just telling you. But nonetheless, we can deal with that. But anyway, we're going to get ready for our prayer right now. Sherita and TC has got a song for us. We'll let them do that right after the prayer time, and that'll give us some good power and anointing for the preaching tonight. So we'll do that. But anyway, as far as prayer requests, still praying for Mary Roberts, that, again, had some blood pressure issues. Kathy Cash just texted me a minute ago. Peach Scruggs is in the hospital, and she is doing somewhat better. May be getting to come home in the next 2 or 3 days. I know there, from what it sounded, with the fluid building up on her arms and stuff, it didn't really sound good there for a while. So we certainly want to keep her in prayer. She's not out of the woodworks yet, but we need to keep her in that prayer. Karen Grayson, some more treatments that she has to take, 3 more. And we'll keep her in prayer. Judy Hall, again, I believe that's going to be on the 11th that she's possibly having something done. I hope I haven't got that mixed up. And then, again, Shelby, has she had her baby yet, Patty? Anybody heard anything?
Not that
heard. Okay, I'm not a big Facebook knowing person, but I've heard people say that things are on there, but she's not had the baby yet. So certainly want to pray for her and all these mamas that are about to bring forth some youth. And then we've got some people that are traveling. Actually, I don't give names about that because I never know who all's listening or whatever. But anyway, praying for some families that are traveling and keep that in prayer. I think that's the main ones that I wanted to mention right now. We've got a host of others. Still praying for Dallas Intimate. She hadn't been here tonight, but her family there in Panama talked about having the cars shot up and everything else. So there's some violence going on over there in Panama right now, too. Again, I'm thinking this is with her family particularly, but we certainly want to keep them in prayer. And again, for all those dealing with cancer, COVID, and all the other health issues. Prayer requests from you all, and we want to keep your wife, Melanie, in prayer for
please,
her heart.
Please and thank you. And for you and your wife, for her back situation and you together as the head, and as you try to lead us and be patient with us, and we appreciate that. But this ministry, and when I always ask for prayer for the ministry, I am talking, of course, about this church, but I also mean when I go out to nursing homes, when Steve's group goes out to a church,
all of us,
when these two down here are ministering, the ministry, that it will grow and strengthen and will get souls in while there's still time. Because just like the trades are falling away, everything else is falling apart, and we're running out of time. Please pray for the ministry.
Yes, yes. Absolutely. Other prayer requests?
Gary Higdon.
Yes, and I did text Tracy. Was actually at lunch, and she texted me back, said he was doing better. He had a little episode this morning, had some hard time breathing, but everything's straightened out on that. So he is doing better, but we do want to keep him in prayer. I don't think he's felt well for the past couple weeks, so him and Tracy both need our prayers. So. But anyway, yes, TC.
Bereaved families with grieving hearts.
Oh, amen. Amen. all those that have had loved ones to pass away for sure. Other prayer requests, Serena?
I have a prayer, but also a praise report.
We'll take that too.
So not many of the church knew, but I know you knew and you were praying, but my dad was homeless there for a long time. And I just want to praise God that he actually did find a job, and he's got $25 an hour, which is amazing.
Wow.
When you don't have any education or anything. But also, not only that, last week, he works in the West End. It's a new semi-truck place that just opened up, and I got to meet his boss, and it's just so amazing how God has worked it out, because she is a true woman of faith. Her husband's of faith. And actually, their company is called YGN, but its initials for Yegaton, which means an African ownership of God. Mm-hmm. So she is a heavy Christian, and she told me, she was like, your dad believes in the Lord, right? Like, you know, was wanting me to testify for him. And I just want to praise God because, you know, dad's been through a lot with his health and stuff, but God's not done with him yet, and there's proof that he's trying to reach him.
Amen.
Give the Lord a hand for that. Others? Prayer requests, praise reports. We'll take all. Anybody else tonight with prayer requests? Okay. Well, if you'd like to stand tonight or not stand, that's up to you. If you'd like to be anointed, you're welcome to come down here. If you need anointed for anything, we'll do that. If not, we're going to agree in prayer here tonight. And then, like I say, we'll do that in the offering. And then I'm going to turn TC and Sherita loose here tonight. We're so glad to see them back here with us tonight. And I consider them extended part of our family here, too. So we appreciate them. But anyway, let's agree in prayer if nobody's wanting to come down for a special prayer. Father God, we just thank you tonight, Lord, for allowing us to gather in this house this evening. We thank you, Lord, for those that have blessed this place with their presence. And Lord, most of all, we thank you for your presence. And God, we welcome you, Holy Spirit, to fill this place, Lord, to overflowing with your power and your anointing.
Amen.
Lord, we may not be able to get the people in here all the time, but Lord, if we get the Spirit, I'm sure the people will follow.
Amen.
When that Spirit moves the right way. And God, we just ask for your sweet anointing.
Yes.
God, for the great glory of God to fall upon us, Lord.
Yes.
And God, may we seek you with all our heart, not just
yes.
with a part of it, but with all of it, Lord. God, your word says to enter into your gates with thanksgiving and to enter into your courts with praise, Lord. May we come into that holy of holiest places, Lord.
Yes.
We ask you tonight, Lord, that you touch the needs of people tonight, Lord. People that have had blood pressure problems, people that have had heart issues, people that have had surgeries, and people are taking treatments, Lord, for God, those that are dealing with back problems, and Lord, others that are dealing with diabetes and all the different issues, Lord, as our brother was talking about people that have had loved ones to pass away, Lord. God, we just pray for encouragement and strength, Lord, when we know a heart is broken, Lord. You're the only one that can help even partially mend it, Lord, and how we pray for that, Lord. How we pray for the ministries, as Brother David was talking about, so many things. God, let us not just spin our wheels to be doing something, Lord, but help us to do whatever we do.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
to your glory and honor, that, Lord, you would be glorified.
Praise
God, we do pray tonight, Lord, for Peach Scruggs, and we do thank you that, again, our last report is better than what it's been sounding, and I just pray that you'll lift her up off that bed of affliction and add to her days, weeks, months, and even years to her life, if you tarry. Again, for others that have been mentioned tonight, Lord, for what things that are up on our hearts tonight, Lord. Lord, I don't know that we ask for a show of hands, but all of us, Lord, have things in our hearts, Lord, that we're needing prayer for, and we just, maybe there's some secret things, Lord, that only you and some of us know of, and God, how we pray for that. How we thank you, Lord, of testimonies, Lord, of how you took, Lord, those that have no place to go and give them a great place to go with you, Lord. And we just pray that you'll continue to touch and move upon lives.
Yeah.
God, we ask for the sweet Holy Spirit once again just to bless the continuance of this service.
Yes.
Lord, for the things that we have going on this week, Lord, not to mention them all again, but Lord, may everything that's done be done to your glory and honor. Have your way in all of our lives. And again, Lord, for these needs, we just continue to place them in your hands. And God, again, Lord, let us remember our country. Lord, I know we're going to be having a prayer time this week, but Lord, we need to be praying for America every day, Lord.
Yes.
And how we do pray for the leadership of this land, Lord. How we pray for, again, those in authority to be under your authoritarianship instead of the Antichrist spirit. And how we pray, God, for our military, our police departments, our fire departments, medical departments, EMSs, farmers, for all those that protect and serve, that you'll protect them. For the people in Ukraine, we pray for them as well. And pray for those that are being so violent against them and others. We just pray, God, that you'd open their eyes to truth, help them to see the light of Christ, Lord. And again, Lord, for a great, a move of a revival spirit in the land today.
Yes.
And again, Lord, have your way here tonight. And for every need, those that will be watching and listening another time, we lift up their needs as well. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. And all God's children said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Is Tom back here? Would you mind doing the offering for us? How many of you all believe that song that we sung in tribute to Bobby? And I think Bobby was singing in tribute all the days of his life to God. My God is real.
Amen.
We believe that tonight. Let's trust in that. Not just overall from what I'm talking about in our lives. Praise God. But Lord, we ask you tonight also, Lord, for this offering that you bless it, use it for your kingdom.
Yes.
For those that give, we pray a blessing. And for those that have not to give, for their needs as well. In Jesus' name.
Yes, yes. Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You guys go back.
To be here in the house of God.
Amen.
To minister this song to your spirit. Delighted because we are welcome in the house of God because of your hospitality and Pastor Nayland's love for Christ and for us. And we reciprocate that same love back to our pastor and to you, the body of Christ. So thank you for allowing us to share our faith with this song. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. He counts the stars, one and all. He knows how much sand is on the shore. He sees every sparrow that falls. He made the mountains and the sea. He's in control of everything. All creatures, great and small. He knows my name. Every step that I take. Every move that I make, every tear that I cry, 'cause he knows my name. When I'm overwhelmed by the pain, I can't see the light of day. I know I'll be just fine, 'cause he knows my name. I don't know what tomorrow will bring. I can't tell you what's in store. I don't know a lot of things. I don't have the answers to the
questions alive, but I know in whom I have believed.
Amen.
'Cause he knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry. 'Cause he knows my name when I'm overwhelmed by the pain. I can't see the light of day, I know I'll be just fine. 'Cause he knows my name, he knows my name, he knows my name.
Amen. Man, God bless you, brother. You believe that tonight, he knows your name?
Amen.
I want to ask you tonight to get your Bible, turn over to the book of Luke, Luke's Gospel, the 12th chapter. I may get to that, I may not. I've got a couple of things I want to share tonight. You know, we've been talking about this morning the potter and the clay, and you know, we talked about this morning, we actually used the Play-Doh method here and pulled out our Play-Doh and showed how God, again, has formed us, even in our mother's womb, and how when something gets marred and messed up, God can take that mess and make it over again.
Amen.
You know, the neat thing about it is he can make it over and over again.
Amen.
I almost give that Play-Doh away. I'm so glad I need it. That's a stress ball. But yeah. But remember that. God.
Amen.
He's the one that's made us. God, he's the one that's formed us. And you know, I like that verse that we read there in Jeremiah this morning. Before I formed you. You got to get that in your spirit. You know, I was pushing that. I know I said it over and over again. But it says, God speaking, before he formed you.
That's right.
You're not an accident.
Amen.
You're not a mistake.
No.
Amen.
You're not, you know, anything. It's not something that somebody did wrong or somebody did right. God, a matter of fact, it talks about Jeremiah, but do you know that he's the same with everybody? Before you was even formed, you was already thought of, not by your parents,
mm-hmm,
biological, adopted, or anything. You was thought of by God before you was even made. I want to read something. I don't know if it'll take very long or not, but it's Sunday night, so I'm assuming we got a little time here. Dottie Roberts gave this to me. And it says, if God should speak. And it deals with the Lord's Prayer, and I know we could have turned there, but I'm still planning on getting to Luke here in a minute. It says, if God should speak, and it says, our Father which art in heaven. Yes? Don't interrupt me, I'm praying. But you called me. Called you. I didn't call you, I'm praying. Our Father which art in heaven. There you did it again. Did what? Called me. You said our Father which art in heaven. Here I am. What's on your mind? But I didn't mean anything bad. I was, you know, just saying my prayers for the day. I always say the Lord's Prayer. It makes me feel good. Kind of like getting a duty done. All right? Go on. Hallowed be thy name. Hold it. What do you mean by that? By what? By hallowed be thy name. It means, good grief, I don't know what it means. How should I know? It's just a part of the prayer. By the way, what does it mean? It means honored. It means holy. It means wonderful. Hey, that makes sense. I never thought about what hallowed meant before. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Do you really mean that? Sure, why not? What are you doing about it? Doing? Nothing, I guess. I just think it would be kind of neat if you could get control of everything down here like you have up there. Have I got control of you?
Mm.
Well, I go to church. That isn't what I asked you. What about your bad temper? You've really got a problem there, you know. And then there's the way you spend your money. All on yourself. And what about that kind of books you've been reading? Oh, stop picking on me. I'm just as good as some of the rest of those people at church. Excuse me. I thought you was praying for my will to be done. If that is to happen, it will have to start with the ones who are praying for it. Man. Like you, for example. Oh, all right, I guess. I do have some hang-ups. Now that you mention it, I could probably name some others, so could I. I haven't thought about it very much until now, but I really would like to cut out some of those things. I would like to, you know, be really free. Good. Now we're getting somewhere. Well, we'll work together, you and I. Some victories can truly be won. I'm proud of you. Look, Lord, I need to finish up here. This is taking a lot longer than it usually does. Give us this day our daily bread. You need to cut out on that bread. You're overweight. Hey, wait a minute. What is this, criticize me day? Here I was doing my religious duty and all of a sudden you break in and remind me of all my hang-ups. Praying is a dangerous thing. You could wind up changed, you know. That's what I'm trying to get across to you. You called me and here I am. It's too late to stop now. Keep praying. I'm interested in the next part of your prayer. I'm scared to. Scared of what? I know what you'll say. Try me and see. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. What about Anne? See, I knew it. I knew you would bring her up. My Lord, she told lies about me, spread stories about my family. She never paid me back the debt she owed. I swore to get even with her, but your prayer, what about your prayer? I didn't mean it. Well, at least you're honest. But it's not much fun carrying that load of bitterness around inside, is it? No, but I feel better as soon as I get even. Boy, have I got some plans for that neighbor. She'll wish she had never moved here into this neighborhood. You won't feel any better. You'll feel worse. Revenge isn't sweet. Think of how unhappy you already are. But I can change all that. You can. How? Forgive Ann. Then I'll forgive you. Then the hate and the sin will be Ann's problem and not yours. You have settled it in your heart. Oh, you're right. You always are. And more than that, I want to receive. I want to revenge Anna. I want to be right with you. All right. I forgive her. Help her to find the right road in life, Lord. She's bound to be awfully miserable. Now that I think about it, anybody who goes around doing the things that she does to others has to be out of the way some way, somehow. Show her the right way. There now, wonderful. How do you feel? Not bad at all. In fact, I feel pretty good. You know, I don't think I'll have to go to bed uptight tonight for the first time since I can remember. Maybe I won't be so tired from now on because I'm getting enough rest. You're not through with your prayer. Go on. Oh, all right. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Good, I'll do that. Just don't put yourself in a place where you can be tempted. Amen. What do you mean by that? Don't turn on a TV when you know the laundry needs to be done and the house needs to be picked up. Also, about the time you spend coffeeing with your friends, if you can't influence the conversation to positive things, perhaps you should rethink the value of those friendships. Another thing, your neighbors and your friends shouldn't be your standard for keeping up. Please don't use me for an escape hatch. I don't understand the last part. Sure you do. You've done it a lot of times. You get caught in a bad situation and you get into trouble and then you come running to me, Lord, help me out of this mess. And I promise you I'll never do it again. You remember some of those bargains you tried to make with me? Yeah, I'm ashamed, Lord. I really am. What bargain are you remembering? Well, there was the night that Bill was gone and the children and I were home alone. The wind was blowing so hard I thought the roof would go away any minute, and tornado warnings were out. And I remember praying, oh God, if you spare us, I'll never skip my devotions again. I protected you, but you didn't keep your promise, did you? I'm sorry, Lord. I really am. Up until now, I thought that if I just prayed the Lord's Prayer every day, then I could do what I liked. I didn't expect anything to happen like it did. Go ahead and finish your prayer, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Do you know what would bring me glory? What would really make me happy? No, but I'd like to know. I want now to please you. I can see what a mess I've made of my life. Excuse me. And I can see how great it would be really to be one of your followers. You just answered a question. I did? Yes. The thing that would bring me glory is to have people like you truly love me. Mm-hmm. And I see that happening between us. Now that some of these old sins are exposed out of the way, there's no telling what we can do together. Lord, let's see what we can make it mean. Okay? Yes, let's see. I thought that was a pretty neat reading.
Amen.
How many times do we just pray repetitious prayers? There went all my Play-Doh. I just lost 5 people there. I was representing them as people this morning. But anyway, how many times have we prayed prayers? And it's just because it's the time of prayer. We get up, and again, as I say, that's a part of my morning devotion. But is it more than just a devotion? Is it something from our hearts that we really seek? Tonight, here in Luke chapter 12, I want to start with verse 15. If we were to read out of John 12:43, I'm not going there tonight. It says, they love the praises of man more than the praises of God. I think that's what affects our prayer time sometimes also, folks. We're more concerned about what, again, I can get out of it, not what God can get out of me. How many of us remember asking God just to give me nothing? I don't want nothing today, Lord. I just want to spend some time with you.
Amen.
How many times have we prayed a prayer like that? There might be some times of desperation we've prayed prayers like that, but wouldn't it be wonderful? And again, I know, you know, the Bible says it's God's good pleasure to give good gifts to His children. I know that. I'm not telling you to never ask for nothing again. I'd be a mess if I couldn't ask for God to give me something, because I need Him every day of my life and every situation.
Amen.
But wouldn't it be nice if I could just go to God and say, Lord, I just want to spend some time with you today.
Amen.
I just want you to show up. You know, if I got to stay here all day and just shut everything down, I want you to show up. That's what really matters. That would be wonderful. Here in Luke 12:15, and he said unto them, take heed and beware of covetousness. For a man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth.
Amen.
Oh, I need some more. Mm-hmm. No, I greed some more. Mm. Most of the time it's about greed. How many of you have got closets that are so full you can't get nothing else in them? How many of you have got garages that are so packed you don't know where you're going to put anything else at? Mm-hmm. How many of you have got cars that fill up the driveway and you don't even know where you're going to park somebody else at? I'm not saying everybody, but what I'm saying is how many of us has got excess of everything? Mm-hmm. Maybe they're not the fanciest and nicest, but who cares? Wow. If I could just get to where I just wasn't after things,
amen,
but after the one that gives those things,
amen,
that would be wonderful. Now you spake a parable unto them, saying, the ground of a certain rich man brought forth plentiful. And he thought within himself, saying, what shall, and I always like marking this, what shall I do? Because I have no room where to bestow my fruits. And he said, this will I do. I will pull down my barns and build greater. And there will I bestow all my fruits and my goods. And I, notice those eyes?
Yes.
You could also go back to Isaiah 14. A guy by the name of Satan, Lucifer. He said, I will exalt my throne above God. I will be like the Most High. I will do all these things. And remember, Jesus made a statement, I saw Satan fall like lightning. Mm-hmm. That's what took the devil down. Mm-hmm. I will be like the Most High. I will be exalted above all. I. That's what people get into. Mm-hmm. We've all been guilty. We can say we haven't, but we've all had the eyes. How many times do you get up and say, I need help. I need this. I need that. Again, there's nothing wrong with that, but how far do we take that? Go back to verse 19. It says, I will say to my soul, soul, thou hast much goods laid up for many years. Take thine ease, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said unto him, and we shouldn't say this too many times, thou fool, this night thy soul shall be required of thee. Then whose shall those things be which thou hast provided? Mm-hmm. So is he that layeth up treasures for himself and is not rich toward God. Isn't money the root of all evil?
Amen.
No.
The love of it.
The love of it.
That's the basics of it, isn't it? Money's a tool. But money's actually an instrument that we use for barter trade and all those things. But when all we want is things, and again, we don't want the one that provides those things, something's missing. Something isn't there, you know. It's nice to give gifts. It's nice to receive gifts. But isn't the greatest gift of all the one that God's given us through His Son, Jesus
Amen.
Christ?
Amen.
I remember right, it says, greater love hath no man than this. Mm-hmm. Than a man lay down his life for another over there in John 15. You remember who did that for you?
Amen.
I say that in funerals when we're talking about military, but basically that's who is talking about. Jesus laid down his life for you and me and all of us in here. Man, he's given us so much. But then when we get all caught up in the things of this world, and instead of laying up treasures in heaven where moth and rust doth not corrupt and where thieves can't break through, we get caught up in treasures here on this earth.
Amen.
And like I say, every one of us could probably afford to have a dozen yard sales this summer, a dozen garage sales, get rid of this, that, and the other, because we're packed with stuff. I'm not down in, again, things. But look at who gives us these things, who's blessed Amen. Us with the ability to have what we have. Man, I got up this morning, I could breathe. That's a wonderful thing.
Amen.
I got up this morning, I could walk. I could move my hands, and I got out of bed, and all those things, and all the blessings we've got.
Yes.
Amen. I didn't get that for nothing. God paid for that.
Amen.
Remember I said earlier, Jeremiah 1, I knew you before I formed you. Wow, even in your mother's belly. And I sanctified you before you come out of your mother's womb?
Yes.
Wow. That's wonderful. And that's also God. And he said unto his disciples, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat, neither for the body, what you shall put on. The life is more than meat, talking about food, and the body is more than raiment, clothing. Consider the ravens, for they neither sow nor reap. which neither have storehouses nor barns, and God feedeth them, how much more are ye better than fowls? Have you ever seen a bird have a heart attack or a stroke? What am I talking about? How many of you get stressed out because you're concerned or overly concerned or even worried about the things that you can't do a whole lot about sometimes? Even a bird's smart enough to know that God's going to provide for them. I mean, you know, they take care of them. And they don't even have to build a barn. I mean, they don't need to store it up. You say, well, it's getting harder for them because of all the stuff we built around. They still find something, don't they? If they don't find it in the field, I got a feeling our Heavenly Father can find them what they need. How about you?
He can, amen.
Amen.
I think He can take care of the ravens. And it says, consider the ravens, for they neither sow nor reap, which neither have storehouses nor barns, and God feedeth them. How much more are ye better than the fowls? And which of you, with taking thought, can add to his stature or his height 1 cubit or 1.5 feet possibly? If ye then be not able to do that thing which is least, why take ye thought for the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They toil not, they spin not. Yet I say unto you that Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. When you look at nature and what God has blessed us with, when you look, you know, I know next week is Mother's Day, and be giving flowers away and all that stuff, and all the women, they like them pretty flowers and stuff. The men are not so much. We like to mow them. Well, anyway, it's not always the same way, but again, the beauty of the flowers and all that. And yes, we do like the beauty, but, you know, only God can create that. Only God can make that, because it come up from a seed. It come up and germinated, and it made something that was beautiful.
Amen.
Just like the sunrise, just like the sunset, just like, you know, I can still remember. I'm not a big Florida person. I've been there a few times. I don't know that I'll ever go again because it's such a long drive. My wife has a hard time with her back. But I can remember going to Florida and getting up just so I could watch the sun come up over the ocean. I can remember one time at Cocoa Beach, we got up and there was a little walkway, and I've still got a picture. Of course, it's on a cell phone. I'd have to go back 3 or 4 cell phones to find it. Probably nobody ever does the pictures develop, and we say we will, but we don't. Or at least this guy don't. But I can remember getting up one morning and was taking pictures while the sun was coming up, and while I was walking over a balcony, it looked just like a cross with the sun coming. Man, it just blessed my heart. I was ready to cry. I mean, it was beautiful to see a cross with a sunrise coming up over the ocean. Mm-hmm. It's like only God can do that.
Amen.
Only God can make the beauty that we see in nature. And again, I'm not a nature freak, because again, it's God's creation. You know, I don't want to become a worshiper of the creation or the creator, as Romans talks about. But at the same time, God's the one to give it to us, isn't He?
Amen.
God's the one that blessed us with it. It says, if then God, verse 28, if then God so clothed the grass which is today in the field, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, how much more will He clothe you, O ye little faith? And seek not ye what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, neither be ye of a doubtful mind. For all these things do the nations of the world seek after, and your Father knoweth that you have need of these things. Mm-hmm. But rather seek ye.
Yes, amen.
God, it's me again. Remember the prayer we was talking about earlier? Here I am. Do we really believe that? But rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you.
Amen.
Is it really bad to be so heavenly minded that you're no earthly good? Because most people are so earthly minded, they're no heavenly good. I'm not down in that saying, because I know they've talked about holier than thou many times, but wouldn't it be nice if we could keep our mind on the things of God more than the things
Amen.
Of this world? I know you got to go through life. I know you got jobs, ministries, and in everything you got to do things. I understand that. You can't just totally be in the clouds all the time. But at the same time, just to be God-oriented.
Yes.
Wouldn't it be awesome if every time you walked out the door, if you went out the door, glory to God, the glory of God went with you. I went to JC and the glory of God went with me. I went to Walmart and the glory of God went with me.
Amen.
I walked into that car shop and the glory of God went with me. And I didn't have to beat nobody over the head and say, man, I got a Bible and I'm going to get you straightened out. All of a sudden somebody said, I want what you got.
Amen. Amen.
There's something about you I like. There's something in you I want to get a hold of. This is great. There's something special in you. I don't understand it. I don't know where it comes from. Instead of having to beg somebody to listen to you, wouldn't it be nice if we had so much of the love of God and the glory of God shining on us that people would want to ask us?
Amen.
When I read in the Bible sometimes, you know, it didn't say that they beat him over the head to get him saved. If I remember right, it said, what must I do to be saved?
Amen.
You know, there's time and time again, something got a hold of people.
Amen.
That instead of, you know, I'm not downing that we should preach and teach and share and try to get this thing out as good. But boy, it's got to take the glory of God to get out there, doesn't it?
Yes.
It takes the spirit of His grace and His mercy to touch on people's lives.
Amen.
But folks, I've not got it all figured out yet. Do you?
No.
No.
If we did, we'd be packed out tonight, wouldn't we?
Amen.
If we did, we might not even need to be packed out tonight because we might just be on the other side of glory.
Amen.
Wouldn't it be nice if we could be like that guy named... What was that name? Enoch, yeah. Remember him?
Yeah.
What did the Bible say over in Hebrews 11, about the fifth verse? I think it says he walked with God.
Yeah.
And he was not, for God took him.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be wonderful if we were just walking with God one day and he just took us home?
Yeah.
Amen.
What's that show Michael Landon played in, Highway to Heaven? Just me walking down the road, glory to God, just whoo,
yeah.
Right up in the glory land.
Amen.
Wouldn't that be marvelous?
Amen, it would.
Wow. But you know what? There's still a reason for us being here.
Amen.
That's because God wants to instill us with things that this world don't have. And instill us with such power that we don't have either.
Amen.
We get caught up in our own strength.
Yeah.
I tell you what, I had a birthday this week. Now, I'm not bragging about that, but I realized something. I don't have the power I used to have. It's not as good as it used to be. It's not as strong as it used to be. But you know something else I'm realizing, just like Paul said? In my weakness,
yes.
His strength is made perfect.
Amen.
Amen.
When I get to where I can't go no more, God picks me up.
Amen.
When I get to where I think I can do everything, God lets me alone. Go ahead. Think you can do it on your own. Go ahead. You figure it out. Go ahead. You get your strength and your abilities and all your stuff in it. And sometimes you can think you're doing real good religious things sometimes. But it's got to be God. It's got to be the work of the Holy Spirit. And when God gets a hold of it, that's when it really matters. Wow. And seek not ye that what you shall eat or what you shall drink, neither be of a doubtful mind. For all these things do the nations of the world seek after. And your Father knoweth that you have need of these things. But rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you. God knows you need food. God knows you need clothing. God takes care of your every need, don't He?
Yes, He does.
Amen.
Isn't there a verse over in Philippians 4, about 19?
Mm-hmm.
My God shall maybe, sometimes, possibly. No, it says, my God shall supply all your needs according to His riches and glory.
Amen.
Did say greeds. Remember we talked about that? I. But fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell that you have and give alms. Provide yourself bags which wax not old. A treasure in the heavens that fadeth not, where no thief approacheth, neither moth corrupt. For where your treasures is, there will your heart be also. Let your loins be girded about and your light's burning. And ye yourselves like unto men that wait for their Lord, when he will return from the wedding. Is that wedding bells I hear? That when he cometh and knocketh, they may open unto him immediately. You remember that, don't you, David?
Sure do.
You did it many a time.
Sure do.
Blessed are those servants whom the Lord, when he cometh, shall find watching. I think it's over there in 2 Timothy 4. Paul was talking to Timothy. He said, I fought a good fight. I finished my course. I've kept the faith. And he says, henceforth there's laid up for me a crown of righteousness, and not only unto me, but to all those
who believe,
that look for his appearance.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you looking for him to come again?
Amen.
Are you looking for him to show up?
Please.
Beware, he may show up when you least expect him sometimes.
Amen.
You may be watching the wrong thing on the TV that day. You may be looking at the wrong thing on the internet. You may be in the wrong place. If Jesus was to knock at your door today at your house, would you be able to let him in, or would you have to hide a few things? Would you have to shut off a few things? Would you have to cover up a few things? Wow. Keep that in mind. But anyway, what verse did I just finish up?
35.
Let your loins be girded about, and your lights burning, and ye yourselves like unto man that wait for their Lord when he will return from the wedding, that when he cometh and knocketh, they may open unto him immediately. Blessed are those servants whom the Lord, when he cometh, shall find watching. Verily I say unto you that he shall gird himself and make them to sit down to meat, and will come forth and serve them. And if he shall come in the second watch, or come in the third watch, and find them so, blessed are those servants. And this know, that if the good man of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not have suffered his house to be broken through. Be ye therefore ready also, for the Son of Man cometh at an hour when ye think not.
Amen.
Reading on here just a little further here, it says, then Peter said unto him, Lord, speakest thou this parable unto us, or even to all? And the Lord said, who then is that faithful and wise steward, whom his Lord shall make ruler over his household, to give them their portions of meat in due season? Blessed is that servant whom his Lord, when he cometh, shall find so doing. What is the Lord going to find you doing when he comes back?
Amen.
What's he going to find you getting into, or looking at, or being a part of? Of a truth I say unto you, that he will make him ruler over all that he hath. But and if that servant say in his heart, my Lord delayeth. Oh, you got to go there a little bit. 2 Peter 3. A day is a thousand years, and a thousand years is a day. God's not slack concerning his promises.
Right.
Man count slackness, but God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Because before that they said, you know, it's always been the same. You know, just like they said about the Father before, everything's still the same. The world's still the same messed up deal of the situations. And, you know, they keep saying, you know, Jesus is coming back, and I know that his coming's almost. And they keep talking about that second coming. They keep talking about, you know, keep your eyes on the eastern sky and keep your mind on the things. And he's going to come. And they've been... My great-grandpa talked about that. My granddaddy talked about that. My daddy talked about that. I've heard so many people talk about that. And there's nothing changed. Beware.
Amen.
For such an hour as you think not.
When he comes.
Your Lord doth come.
Amen.
Oh, wow. Wow. Of a truth I say in you, verse 44, that he will make him ruler over all that he hath. But in of that servant say in his heart, my Lord delayeth his coming, and shall begin to beat the manservants and maidens, and to eat and to drink and to be drunken. The Lord of that servant will come in a day when he looketh not for him, and in an hour when he is not aware, and will cut him asunder, and will appoint him his portions with the
unbelievers.
Unbelievers. Wow. I don't want to be a part of that deal, do you?
No.
No, sir.
And that servant which knew his Lord's will and prepared not himself, neither did according to his will, shall be beaten with many stripes. But he that knew not and did commit things worthy of stripes shall be beaten with few stripes. And whether judgment we're talking about. For unto whomsoever much is given of him shall much be required. And to whom man hath committed much of him, they will ask the more. I'm come to send fire on the earth. And what will I if it be already kindled? You know, we were talking about the potter's clay again this morning. You know, the things about the potter, again, that clay, he has to water it, get it all ready, and then he kneads it and keeps pushing it and getting all the infirmities out of it. And then all of a sudden he throws it into, that fire, and they heat it up hundreds of degrees. And when it goes through the fire, again, I learned this in art years ago. I didn't do very good in art, but I made some ashtrays, and they were smoking when they come out. I'll tell you that blew to pieces because they had too many air bubbles in them. You know why? Because I rushed them through. I didn't take time to get it right. How many of you know God's taking time to do things right with you and me? God's getting that junk out of us that we don't want to get rid of. God's working on those things that we don't think needs to be worked out, and we keep struggling with God. And God, you know it's all right of a little bit of that, and this is all right. You know, a little leaven leaveneth the whole lump.
Amen.
But that baptized me with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Amen.
Man, I want all the gifts of the Spirit. Man, I want to flow like a butterfly, sting like a bee, and all that stuff. But you know, at the same time, that fire is burning. And man, yeah, tongues of fire and all that stuff. But I mean, there's some fire burning inside of us, and it's getting rid of some junk inside of us. You know those problems that you go through, those trials and the tribulations that you go through, and you can't understand, why is God letting me go through this? Sometimes it's not God letting you go through that. Sometimes it's God working you through. God's trying to work some things out in all of our lives. You know, I find out the more I want to get closer to God, the harder it gets.
Amen.
Because just as sure as you want to get closer to God, Satan is coming against you, against your mind, your will, your emotions, and he's trying to strike at you, and he's trying to put things in you that you don't need in you, and he's trying to keep you from going places you need to go and taking you places you shouldn't go. And I'm not talking about filthy and honorary. I think Christians were so good about putting on the act, but I'm talking about just sometimes silly things that really don't amount to nothing.
Amen.
And God's wanting to do a work in our life.
Amen.
Wow.
Amen.
Aren't you glad he's still working on you?
Yes, amen.
He said, I've come to send fire on the earth, and what will I? It would be already kindled. But I have a baptism to be baptized with, and how I'm straitened till it be accomplished. Suppose ye that I'm come to give peace on earth, I tell ye nay, but rather division. Oh, dear goodness. I thought we got to get along with everything and everybody. Some things you got to separate from.
Yep.
Like I say, when I got saved, man, I had some good friends before I got saved. And I mean, they were my drinking buddies and party, and they loved to come over, and especially when you supplied the booze and all that stuff. And man, but you know what? When you quit supplying the booze and you started that Jesus talking and started talking some different languages and the cussing went out and some of that driveway that used to be packed, it kept getting less and less. Till there wasn't none coming. I remember one guy coming in wanting to bring a case of beer and talk to me. When I told him he couldn't bring his beer in, but he was welcome, they both left. Him and the booze. And again, you all know what I'm talking about. And again, that was my hang up. What was yours? I don't know.
Amen.
Whatever it was. But again, for from henceforth there shall be five in the And one house divided, three against two, and two against three. The father shall be divided against the son, and the son against the father, and the mother against the daughter against the mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. When you get saved, people are not always going to love you no more. They're not going to want to be around you a lot of times. Hopefully in the future they will. You know, some of my friends come back around. Some of them didn't. Some of them died. Some of them, I don't know where they went in eternity. Some of them are still around, but they're not around me. Some of them I still feel bad about because I influenced them the wrong way, but again, they had to make their decision just like I did. And he said also to the people, when you see a cloud rise out of the west, straightway you say, there cometh a shower, and so it is. And when you see the south wind blow, you say, there will be heat, and it cometh to pass. Oh, there's a dirty word. Ye, what's that word? Hypocrites. What's a hypocrite? A great pretender. Mm-hmm. Somebody puts on a good show, mm-hmm. but they're not real. Mm-hmm. You can discern the face of the sky and of the earth, but how is it that you do not discern the time? Yea, and why even of yourself judge ye not what is right? When thou goest with that adversary to the magistrates, as thou art in the way, give diligence that thou mayest be delivered from him, lest he hale thee to the judge, and the judge deliver thee to the officers, and the officer cast thee into the prison. I tell thee, thou shalt not depart thence till thou hast paid the very last mite. Don't be a great pretender.
Amen.
One of these days we're all going to stand, not in the judgment of men, but in the judgment of God. You know, the Bible says judgment begins in the house of God.
Yeah.
It also says, if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the sinner and unbeliever be? I mean, they're going to be a mess. Let's be real about our faith, but let's be real about walking in that faith. Praise Amen. God. Let's close in prayer tonight. Let's don't close. Let's just go on with the Lord either way.
Amen.
Let's be in prayer about the things that we've been speaking about.
Amen.
Pray that great things will happen.
Yeah.
We're looking for a move of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
But the first thing He's going to have to move is us.
That's right.
Amen.
He's going to have to take some things and work them out in all of us. Pray for me that God will take anything that would hinder. I want clean hands and a pure heart.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
I struggle with that sometimes, don't you?
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, you're the preacher.
Mm-hmm.
Big deal.
Yeah.
You're human.
Amen.
Yes.
God's got to work on all of us.
Yes. Amen.
Those thoughts, those imaginations,
yes.
strifes and bitterness and whatever Satan can throw at us.
Yes.
What lifted you? Loved it.
Yeah.
Let's stand tonight. Let's close in prayer.
Amen.
Father God, we just thank you tonight, Lord, for allowing us to gather in this house tonight. We thank you, God, for the time in your word. We thank you for testimonies. We thank you, God, for prayer time. We thank you for every part of this day, Lord. We thank you for every person that's blessed this place with their presence. We thank you for the music, for songs, and everything that's been done here tonight. And we just ask you tonight, Lord, as we go to our homes, that you'll keep us safe and in your arms of love. And help us to be an encourager to a lost and dying world. And help us to, again, follow your plans and not this world's. And again, Lord, help us to do as that one scripture says, seek first the kingdom of God.
Amen.
And we thank you for that. Again, till we come together, help us all to stay together in you. And we pray it all in Jesus' name. And all God's children said,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Turn around if you can, shake a hand, tell somebody you love them tonight. And again, come back then. Remember tomorrow night, 7 p.m. for the men's meeting, Tuesday for the women, and then Wednesday church service, Thursday National Day of Prayer, Friday the movie night, Saturday the singing on the square. God bless.
Thank you.